Joe Louis Arena, Detroit, where the Red Wings are perfect in their home games this year. And this game perfectly available to you on high definition from Versus. Marty Turco has started every game for his team in the playoffs since 2003. Chris Osgood has not, but he's made seven straight starts. This becomes the eighth. He has won seven straight. The record is 11. How will this Red Wing team be without Johan Franzen?
Well, I think because of their depth, Doc, they will be fine. But it is a big body, a guy that will take some faceoffs, has had just an outstanding playoff so far, kept it going from a great end of the season, March. But again, other players need to step up and fill the void with Johan Franzen out.
No matter how far away from home you might be, we are thinking of you. This game being seen by our men and women in uniform around the world on AFN, the American Forces Network. 51 in red is Valtteri Filppula. He has moved up to take the center position, the one that Johan Franzen had, and the first drive is a strong one from Michael Samuelson that is sealed up by Turco.
That was a real slow play developing through the neutral zone. Cronwall and Stewart, and then moving the puck up quickly and just getting the puck to the net, and Turco just kind of pinches that right arm onto his side and gives up no second chance opportunity.
48 hours for Dallas to think about game one. What's their mindset here?
You know what? It's pretty simple, Doc.
Oh, here's a steal and a feed in front, and Eriksson backhanded it wide. Onto the back it comes for the hold by Nicklas Grossman. Around behind, and Eriksson with a wonderful chance, but couldn't bury it.
I think it's just about, look, it's one game. It's no big deal. Learn from your mistakes. Let's stay out of the penalty box, as we talked about in the open. Give ourselves a chance. That was a great chance here early in game two.
Valtteri Filppula lays that one in and comes for a change in lines. Mark Fistrick is not in the lineup for Dallas tonight at defense. Instead, Matt Niskanen is. The one change, of course, is Franzen, taking his place on the roster of forwards, Darren McCarty. Hagman a shot that's blocked away by Brett Lebda and laid back out again, nubbed down by Draper for the play on by Dallas Drake. And here's Drake with a drive, and it whistled wide. Breaking to the net was Lebda. Dropping back to... Oh, my! What a hit and a drive! And that one is deflected up and out of play.
Dallas Drake on Stefan Robidoux, and then Chris Draper with an outstanding opportunity up and behind Marty Turco. But Dallas Drake lines up Stefan Robidoux, a good, clean, hard hit, and then the puck ends up on the stick. So again, the support by the Red Wings after the big hit. Wow.
In calmer moments this morning, Mike Babcock said the only thing he didn't like about game one was his team wasn't physical enough.
Well, how about a minute and 23 in? That equals about 4 or 5 hits.
Because everyone sees it, your own guys and the other guys.
Right.
Well, here is Ribeiro. Not gone well for him lately. No goals in the last 5 games. 10 shots over that time, and 9 of those came in the one game, the 4 overtime contest.
He's a league leader, Doc, in shooting percentage. Not a guy that gets a lot of shots. 27 goals in a regular season in 76 games.
Here's Rafalski, flipping it along, and it's left behind by Zetterberg, and the whole play winds up going offside. Take a look at the Radio Shack keys to the game.
Well, good start here early for the Dallas Stars. Pretty simply took 4 minor penalties in period one. And of course, the Detroit physical presence. We just saw it with Dallas Drake and Stefan Robidoux. Better in the faceoff circle for the Dallas Stars. 38% in game one.
Darren McCarty, 25 in red, is out there with Darren Helm, who earlier this year was a part of the Grand Rapids Griffins. Came up late in the year, got to play a little bit, and then in the playoffs emerged in the Nashville series, round number one. Centering pass in front and unable to pull the trigger was Toby Peterson. Thrown back in by Helm. Right back after it, good shoulder by Matt Niskanen. Trying to pull the trigger a little early too was Yuri Hudler. Perhaps butterflies, played on now by Peterson. could not center. Laid right back out by Hoodler and taken on by McCarty and dropped back in.
Boy, a little play there by Brad Winchester. He got the puck into the neutral zone. And Toby Peterson has really good speed. So again, the little plays along the boards for the Dallas Stars. So far, so good for Dave Tippett.
Off a high Detroit stick, that of Cronwall, laid back along, but it is skipping on now for a little feed in front that came from Brad Richards, but is grabbed off and tossed back out again by Samuelson. Could not be sent further by Cleary. Instead, Louis Erickson gives it on back and gets the return from Sergei Zubov.
Not even 3.5 minutes in here to the first period, Doc, and I don't think there's any doubt that Dallas has got their legs from Dallas. Dave Tippett said he thinks after the game he thought his team left his legs in Dallas.
This is Zubov feathering it on through. Brad Richards with the shot, and that one ricocheted off Erickson and is played on by Filppula. Off the glove of the breaking Brad Stewart, who goes back on defense. They have the two bangers out there together. Stewart 23 and Cronwall 55, but now have made a change. And this one has sailed from neutral ice over the glass, and so there'll be no penalty coming from that. 3:47 into a scoreless first period.
Two shots of nothing for Detroit Red Wings, but the turnover. Good play there by Brad Richards to get that stick out in that passing lane and a forehand backhand. A missed opportunity and then that chance again for Toby Peterson in front of the net, Doc. So two really good chances, but nothing to show for it on the shot clock. But a lot of good things going on in the offensive zone to this point for the Dallas Stars.
When your coach has told you we've got to stay out of the box, does that tend to limit your hitting at the start of a game, especially when Dallas Drake laid out a big one?
Yeah, I think so. I think it probably, you know, you want to play. You want to be able to, you know, react first instead of thinking about what you're doing, a stop by Turco. But again, it's just moving your feet, and you took some really soft penalties, a lot of stick infractions in game one.
Mike Modano chopped that one off the shelf. Kirk Maltby hit, bounced off, got it on now for Drake, and it went out of play into the Detroit bench area. Tonight's KFC player profile is on Chris Chelios. We always talk about agent seasons, don't we, and hometown, but look at the number of career playoff games. That's a record.
In important minutes in game one, played 17 minutes, 31 seconds, 4:16 on the penalty kill while his team was shorthanded. It's the second most in all of the game. Matty Nordstrom led everybody in ice time when it comes to the shorthanded situations. But you know what you're going to get from Chris Chelios, and do an outstanding job on the penalty kill.
That one caromed across, and it is forced right back out again by Brian Rafalski. Robida goes down to take the tap from Marty Turco. Chelios, the all-time American-born leader in playoff points. A gross of them, 144, one more than second place Mike Modano, number 9 in white tonight. Though Modano now on the ice right now. Robidaille cranked that one right back in. Zetterberg laid it along, and it is picked up and tucked around behind, but through Zetterberg, and so slogging after that to run off was Datsyuk, but he knew what he was doing as he shook it on free, and a couple of the Dallas Stars collided. Nick Lidstrom took some lumber there. Got it on to Zetterberg, punched back to Rafalski, and they can start to move it the other way. Venerable captain, 16th year in these playoffs for Lidstrom. Saw that one chip back out to center. Red Wings 17 straight years in the playoffs. Zetterberg dropped that Suka shot, and a scorcher got the boards behind. Shunted it back along, and Brendan Morrow is able to get that one. A 4-on-1. Fed on back for Ott. Across Ott, a shot, and it's wide. See every day. Red Wings will probably see it at the next practice several times on video.
Oh, Steve Ott missed the net, Doc. That's a third opportunity right in front of Chris Osgood that the Dallas Stars haven't been able to cash in.
Helm, score!
A great opportunity for the Dallas Stars. It's Darren Helm with a quick wrist shot. It beats Marty Turco to the glove side. And from our Coke Zero goal cam, the positioning behind Marty Turco. And Darren Helm with goal number one in his first career National Hockey League goal. And a 1-0 lead for the Wings.
Came at no small time. He can always tell his grandchildren someday, we just given up a 4-on-1 and the guy missed the net. I came back and Mom and Dad were there. So Maureen and Gary are here from St. Albert's and watching this one tonight, and St. Andrews, I should say, watching this, and probably have hearts racing like he does right now.
Yeah, reading between the lines when he tells that story is, you can't score unless you hit the net.
I guess. Osgood covers this one. Already, we can rifle back in our memory bank and find three glorious missed opportunities for the Stars and one made by Darren Helm.
Well, there's Darren Helm, a 1-0 lead for the Detroit Red Wings. And take a look at our Burger King Telestrator. There's Jurie Hudler. The Red Wings are in the middle of a change. The puck moves up ice. Hudler intercepts it. And now it's an odd man situation. Hudler to Helm. And a 1-0 lead for the Wings.
Mike Modano out for this faceoff against Draper, and he won it cleanly to Sergei Zubov. Angled one off the leg of Draper that went wide, gathered in, and worked out not once but twice by Maltby, who's able to work his way to the corner and throw one. Ricocheted off Grossman and is played back along for the turning Antti Mietinen and popped on back further. The lone assist from Hudler at 5:56. And it is angled back in as Helm got the goal and was just recalling the other day his first time to a hockey rink. He was 3 years old and his mom taught him how to skate. St. Andrews at the community rink. As so often the story of Canadian boys is told. So congratulations to him as Cronwall connects back out with Dallas Drake, who registered a hit that Cronwall would like to see in his own collection and has already this playoff.
We're talking about Darren Helm, Doc. I had a chance to talk to him. He mentioned what an impact that Darren McCarty was because he played a lot with him down the stretch early in the playoffs. This is always talking to him, helping. It's nothing like having a veteran guy and take young guys under their wing and really show them the ropes and talk to them. And a lot of times, Doc, you know, young guys get intimidated, especially come playoff time. You need guys like Darren McCarty who's really worked himself back into the National Hockey League. A lot of issues off the ice, and great to see him back. And certainly knows his role right now with being back in the lineup after being out in game one.
Here's Rafalski, got it on a cross, and Hudler is able to sweep with it. Hudler flipped one that was knocked down by Ribeiro and tossed on back to center where Lebda can give it on a cross and handcuffed Rafalski a bit. That one chopped away from him, and it is worked around behind now and lost by Brad Winchester. Oh, my. What a self-preservation move by Helm just a moment ago to get out of the way of the Ott hit. Here is Ott up with the puck again. Ott laid it to the back, scaled around behind and paddled away to the corner by Chris Osgood.
This line was good in game one, according to Dave Tippett.
Oh, another collision. That was Helm with Peterson, and Helm is able to outlet and bring it on now. Darren McCarty bumped into by Winchester and threw it back in. Winchester got his first playoff experience since being an Edmonton Oiler in the last game. Had 3 points in a series back in 06 against the Red Wings. Run ahead now by Cleary, who wiped out and is going to be speared anyway. This one has popped right back, and it is collared by Chris Chelios, who has Cronwall nearby.
Probably a good thing that Cleary lost his edge because Stefan Robidoux was looking for a little payback after that big hit by Drake.
Up the wing to Dan Cleary. Cleary flipped one in front that is cut off and dealt back around for Louis Erickson. Muscled off a bit by Samuelson. Tries to plow on through and does, and then lifts one to the corner, hoping for a favorable bounce, which doesn't happen. Cronwall gave it across. Chelios laid it out. Samuelson hands it on back as we near the halfway point of period one. One Dallas shot so far. Several opportunities that were wide. Filppula had that one patted down and then somewhat clumsily covered by Turco, but he hangs on to get the halt to play. And let's hear from Bob Harwood.
Well, fellas, in terms of the breakout, Dallas has been rock solid. They've been much more efficient with the puck. They found their wingers. They've moved it up the ice. But as they mentioned, on yesterday's practice day and again this morning. Detroit's at their most dangerous in transition at center ice. I don't think they've solved how to get the puck deep yet. Even though they've had some possession at the other end, they're playing into the hands of a team that knows how to turn on a dime. You saw it in the first goal.
You talked about 5-on-5. That's all we've had so far. What do you think?
It's been good. I mean, Dallas has had their chances. I think they obviously are skating much better. And they're supporting a puck like Bob was talking about, especially in the defensive zone. I think they're doing an even better job in the offensive zone of using their feet and trying to create some chances.
It is a shot by Lehta that ricocheted right back to him. Lost it to Mietinen. Challenged right back again, though. And then it is Chris Draper seeing this one come along and lifted back in. Brad Stewart out on defense now with Lehta as Mike Babcock showing the Dallas Stars a little different combinations. Here's Zuboff with a shot. That one blocked right back across by Dallas Drake. Handled by Mietinen. Has a man with him. It's Hagman. Shot one right in on goal on the block by Osgood. And the lift is over the glass. And they rule a deflection. So no penalty coming from that unless...
I think so, Doc. Yeah. I think it's going to be on Lidstrom.
We're back at the Joe. Dallas trails 1-0. Matthias Nordstrom, much more solid in your end. What about center ice?
Well, that's still somewhere where we have the puck and we go through that center ice. That's where we need to move it a little bit faster so we can get down in there, and because I think we've done a good job down there.
Are you seeing more confidence offensively then?
Yeah, but overall, our game so far, a good start to the game, and right now on the power play.
Eddie, thank you.
Thanks.
All right, Doc.
Okay, Bob. Eddie, thank you for the help on that. The guy with the orange armband overruled the line, right? That's how it works.
And Matty Nordstrom agreed with it.
This is delved along for a centering pass. Ricocheted off of Cleary, held by Ribeiro. Ribeiro shoved it across and it drives. They score! What a rocket! It is Robida that let that shot go. His second goal of the playoffs, his ninth point overall, and now things are even.
Well, what an outstanding pass by Mike Ribeiro. We heard Keith Jones talk about Ribeiro, expecting him to have a big game after a tough little goal in game one. Great pass. And Chris Osgood well out of his net, and a completely wide open net for Stefan Robida. And a big power play goal. And a big goal, I think, in general, Doc, for the Dallas Stars. You don't want to play from behind, especially against a team like Detroit. And a huge specialty team goal there by Robida on the Stars.
They were 0 for 4 in game number one, but are perfect in one attempt here. They came in carrying a road percentage of 25. Here's Cleary feeding one out in front. Gopalin's shot is knocked down by the defense. And so from that can come confidence, and it might be bigger than just 1.0 up on the board. Thrown back off now by Osgood. And kicked on for Brad Stewart, filtered it through to Samuelson, has Cleary and threw it to him. Back now for a feed ahead that is carried on by Cronwall and dumped back in. Brad Richards threw that one, but to Filppula. Then Samuelson, then Filppula crosses, looks to Samuelson, and the pass went through him. And then Samuelson threw one for the bounce to Filppula. Defense changing, and so now getting in position is Lidstrom as this one is dropped back to a corner that he will go to make a play, and we get changes in forwards now for both of the teams. Topolsky to Lidstrom, then on to Chris Draper, moves it across for a shot that shanked across for Dallas Drake, but ricocheted off him. Booming hit by Draper on Antti Mietinen.
Mietinen was the guy that made that good defensive play on Drake.
Offside is called. Hockey Central's watching this. Man rush. Do you think that Keith Jones in even youth hockey was ever a part of a 4-on-1?
He was probably giving it up, yes.
He was the one, right?
No, he was the one that was should have been back there.
Bumped along now, and it is Lehtinen trying to play, but along it comes to Holmstrom, pivots and laid it across to Lidstrom, and Lidstrom passes on out for a toss by Datsyuk over near Zetterberg. Flipped one that's off Zetterberg, backs in Datsyuk, pulled the trigger twice, and the whistle. The goal, they roll a hand pass and back to
referee Mark Jonette, as you called it, Doc, waving with the hand pass. Well, there's Henrik Zetterberg moving in. Boy, he goes off the top of his hand and the top of the glove, and Datsyuk thought they had a goal. It's just with the intent, Doc, of batting the puck. Obviously, the fans here at the Joe don't like it. Remains 1-1.
It is a tight criteria for calling it. It is 2 miles an hour over the speed limit. You're going to do time as well as get the points. And on with this now, and peeling off to lob it back in for the Dallas Stars defense is Mattias Norrström. Locked back on, and Ott fed it back, but it is Chelios to take over. Chelios feeds, and it's off McCarty. Lifted back by Norrström again. Territorially, it's a little different than game one was.
They're very even. And this fourth line, again, has given Dave Tippett a lot of energy. Steve Ott, Toby Peterson, Brad Winchester have been real good every even strength shift they've had.
It says here, Detroit is a cut possession team, something that was written back in October and has stayed true. But it seems like this is about, as you say, even at 50% now. Back it comes to Lidstrom. Shoveled one that is turned aside to the glass by Marty Turco. Kicked back along by Holmstrom. Played out in front by Zetterberg to Lidstrom for a shot. Knocked down in front. They scramble for it. It's Datsyuk. Worked on at the corner. Matt Niskanen with a little forearm shiver on him as a shot was knocked away by Turco. Then he jabbed into Holmstrom. The old equalizer from the old days.
A little bit of a quick stick there by Turco as well to Tomas Holmstrom.
Turned over for an odd man rush, but now Dallas in a change gets three back. It's Datsyuk trying to finesse by, and Louis Erickson says no. Erickson brings it right back the other way for the Stars in this 1-1 tie. Under 6 minutes to go, Ribeiro feeds across, and it's shot by Zubov, went wide. More chances for the Dallas Stars. Zubov pulled it on across. Morrow shoved it right back off the boards to him. Sergei Zubov very deliberately dumped it along, but Datsyuk got it and spun it back out to center.
Fourth great offensive opportunity in the first period by the Dallas Stars, Doc, that have missed the net.
Nice,
Osgood swung it. Lidstrom stepped into there. Lundqvist was the guy that got him. A hooking call is coming up against Dallas. Delayed call is on. They filter it through to Filppula, who's the man fouled, and it is now touched. And Zubov will go to the box. Red Wings power play hasn't had a chance yet. Dallas did. Robidas scored on that tie game.
One at the Joe. Stefan Robidas, playoff goal number 2, 7 assists. That's brand new territory offensively. This, not so much. He's used to it. 5 career and counting broken noses. The latest one dating back, of course, to Anaheim in the first round. Going as far as his career is concerned, through changing pieces of equipment, he says the adjustment has been from plastic iTech over the eyes to plastic iTech with the cage over the mouth for breathing. The full mask actually gives him better vision, fellas. He says the eyes adjust, I breathe better, and obviously when the puck is on his stick, he's seeing it.
Only took 14 seconds on that power play for him to score and get this game even, as it is Nick Lidstrom holding now. Two prominent defensemen have been boxed. Lidstrom had the earlier penalty. Along the half boards now, it is tipped back along by Datsyuk and played by Zetterberg. Then on to Datsyuk. Little shoving at the front of the net. Drive! Score! Zetterberg let it go 2-1.
Well, 3 power play goals in game one. And Tomas Holmstrom going to the front of the net with Matty Norrström. Quick little shot. Turco with a shot. And then the quick pass. Left wing boards to right wing boards. There's Brian Rafalski, defenseman, moving down low. And Henrik Zetterberg with a beautiful one-timer. No hesitation at all. If he has to stop that pass, it gives Turco an opportunity to stop the puck. Great execution by the Red Wings. And they lead by 1.
Phil Fuller dropped it on to Samuelson. Full strength action now, but the scoreboard back in favor of the Red Wings. Back in it comes near Cleary. Chased by Romanoff. Took it away. Dumped it off the boards. Louis Erickson flipped it, but into Cronwall. Up for grabs again. Dallas must retreat. Angles it around behind, and a long toss now goes on for Joel Lundqvist. He had to drop it back further for Grossman.
Both goals, Doc. Very similar. Passes from one side of the ice to the other. No hesitation by the guy receiving. Two goals.
Bank to the back. Nordstrom's shot is wide. Turned on back and a good hit on Filppula by Lundqvist. And the jostling behind. With under 4 minutes to go here in the first period. Neither team needed long to connect on the power play.
Oh, what a move there by Datsyuk to get away from Louis Erickson.
It is Filppula, but an offside is called as Zetterberg. I don't know whether he would still be impressed with that move and that threw the time off or not, but you can understand why.
Well, there's Datsyuk. Here comes Louis Erickson. He thinks he's going to drop it to Nicholas Cronwall, and he kicks it back up and is able to avoid Louis Erickson. I don't think there's any doubt that Erickson thought he was dropping that puck back to the defenseman. Oh, and by the way, I'm just going to drop it to my skate, kick it by in, move up ice.
Datsyuk and Holmstrom got assists on the Zetterberg goal. That's 38 points in 11 and a fraction games for that line in the playoffs this spring.
And what a pass there by Datsyuk, perfectly placed.
So was that one by Zetterberg onto Holmstrom. Dropped it on, and it is tipped back out by Yuri Lehtinen. Coming by now is Lidstrom.
I know Dallas is down here, Doc, in the first period, and we talked about the really the four missed opportunities that they've had. Some great chances. It's been good. It's been a lot better than it was in game one, so they can build off that. Anytime you're playing on the road, especially in the playoffs, like to be even or ahead after the first period.
Well, there's some good video for them to build on, regardless of the score at the end of this period. We've only got 2:54 to go in it. And the puck wound up underneath one of the fallen players, Robidoux getting up.
Oh, that was Datsyuk with a little push from behind on Stefan Robidoux. And Robidoux's talking to referee Mark Jonette. The whistle blew quickly after that. But again, I think for, you know, the Red Wings, they have that ability, Doc, to take advantage of what's given. And look, they are a puck possession type of team, but they can play any way that they dictate, and they can play any way you want. You want to play a dump and chase game and get on the body, they can play that way. You want to trade chances, they would love to be able to do that. Again, I talked about, I think it's been a good start for the Dallas Stars. Only three shots on goal, and they missed the net on at least five or six opportunities, four golden opportunities, probably from what, 20 feet in.
Yeah, especially the four-on-one was close.
Right. And you had your Erickson chance. You had the Peterson chance.
That one deflected wide off of Dallas Drake.
The Zuboff chance as well.
And the Zuboff trying to get it back out, reversed it, and that one caromed as far as Chelios at center.
I think a lot of times, too, Doc, just with that point when you miss the net like that, you're trying to be too fine. I'm going to give the Red Wings some credit. They're getting in those lanes and, you know, maybe taking away the majority of the net, but you know, when you're struggling as an individual or as a team and you're missing the net on your shots, sometimes you just got to put your head down and say, you know what, the old Mike Bossy theory. Just put your head down and shoot for the net, and good things are going to happen.
Well, as a former coach, when you see that happening to your team out there, you're talking a lot at the bench to try to get your confidence back,
right? Absolutely. Say, hey, you know what, we're getting the chances. Let's stay with it. Let's not try to be too fine. Let's just hit the net.
Around this comes for Cronwall. Under 2 minutes to go in the period, as it's Hoetler trying to finesse one through. It came back to him, and he's able to bank it around behind. Zetterberg turning there, has Datsyuk in front. Worked to the outside and is able to turn away from Brad Richards. Crosses now. Richards on him, and the shot is blocked off by Turco. Rebound is gotten by Zetterberg again. Centering pass went off a skate, grabbed off by Richards.
Well, nice play there by Brad Stewart. That opened up a lot of room there for Zetterberg.
Here's Hagman moving in. Shot is wide. Rebound is turned to the slot and punched aside by Richards. Richards with a shot. That one deflected down. And the Red Wings bring it back, and it's Datsyuk curling on. Chip change for the defense of Detroit as Datsyuk worms his way to the outside. Has Zetterberg there, fed one off of Cleary, who was tightly defended by Niskanen, and then a pad stop made by Turco. turned back by Zetterberg and an offside call with a minute six to go in the first, and more stick handling artistry.
Well, the pass from Brad Richards and Nicholas Hagman. Good defense there by the Red Wings. Cronwall Stewart on the back check. He's not allowed to really cut all the way over, Doc, and give himself a better opportunity and free himself with a good opportunity on Chris Osgood. But again, another missed opportunity. And that one, you got to give the Red Wings full marks there by Cronwall back checking, forcing him to shoot the puck wide.
Samuelson played it back along. It is Cleary turning with it there. And then Samuelson, a shot that is grabbed and held by Turco. Turco turns back as if to say quick whistle, but the referees were having to tend to a skirmish there.
Yeah, it was Stefan Robidoux grabbing the stick of Dan Cleary and just throwing it onto the ice.
Well, tomorrow night, the Eastern Conference Final resumes with game number two from Pittsburgh. Flyers and Pens, 7:30 Eastern here on Versus, the national cable home of the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Denny Malkin a couple goals, Mike Richards a couple goals.
They're scary when they get that forecheck going, aren't
get
they?
Going like that.
And you can sure see, as you pointed out two nights ago, the absence of just one defenseman makes a big difference. A shot by Lidstrom is deflected and it trickled wide, played along by Samuelson. Battled for there. Trevor Daley working on him, pinned him so that help could come from Ott. Steve Ott bringing it ahead. 25 years of age for these Dallas Stars. Flew it wide. In to get it is Morrow. Cuts off the icing. To the outside, it's Ribeiro. Not much of a shooting lane, he felt. Turned along by Ott. Right back over for Morrow again in the last 20 of the period. Returns it to Ott. Dropped it around behind. Held there by Ribeiro. Ott drips to the front. Running out of time. And now it's Ribeiro in front. The shot blocked in front. Clear back out of the crease by Lidstrom. 3 seconds to go. One more shot deflected harmlessly down. And the period comes to a close. And Ott is trying to engage Osgood.
A little bit of a mixed bag as far as a line for Dave Tippett. Ott out there. Brendan Morrow did a great job of tying up Philpott, allowing Ott to take the puck to the front of the net. And then the quick little stick. Body position in front of the net. And then Steve Ott having some words with Chris Osgood. An entertaining first period, Doc.
Was indeed. Osgood faced four, got three. Lidstrom got one in the last few seconds. That kept the score in the Red Wings' favor. 2-1. Dodge intermission report after the break.
The Stanley Cup playoffs on Versus are brought to you by Dodge. Introducing the all-new Dodge Journey. If you can dream it, do it. Dodge. Grab life.
About ready to start the second period of this one with the Red Wings ahead 2-1. We could give you statistics, but the most important one was there was a question mark on a returning Dallas Star, but now they have the full complement at the bench.
Yeah, Yuri Lehtinen played 6:19 in that first period, Doc, but had a major collision with Brendan Morrow, which we're going to show everybody. We get our first stoppage here in the second period.
Mike Babcock got his way on the hit department. Remember, he wanted his team to be more physical. 21 hits to 8 Detroit in that first period. Dallas Stars attempted 12, and 5 were off the mark. 3 were blocked, and the other 4 were on goal, as Bill Patrick was pointing out. And along with this is Louis Erickson. Reverses and shot one off the outside of the cage. Cronwall with a nice pull. Oh, he wanted to shovelboard it further, and he was stunned on a hit by Joel Lundqvist. Bouncer is sent back ahead now as far as center by Philpott, but then it careened back over the line offside, and let's look at this here.
Well, in the first period, as you see a Band-Aid across the bridge of the nose of Yuri Lehtinen, Brendan Morrow, face to helmet of Yuri Lehtinen, and took Lehtinen a second to get his bearings, Doc. Good to see the top defensive players in all the National Hockey League when it comes to the right wing position. Yuri Lehtinen back on the bench for Dave Tippett. And also took some stitches near his left eye in game one as well. So a rough four periods for Yuri Lehtinen.
And had the right guy lined up. It's just it wasn't delivered to the right guy. Datsyuk was the one who was trying to stick handle, had his head down trying to make that play. And so ill fortunes. Back ahead now is Draper across for a shot, and that floated wide. Dallas Drake let it go, and it deflected just wide of the cage and is brought back up now by Hagman. Given across to Miettinen, they crisscross, and the lay is back over to Hagman. Jabbed one in front that's forced away by Draper. And the bouncer is turned along by Drake, but handed on back to Trevor Daly. Daly with a wrist shot that's well wide. Bounces on back for Matt Niskanen. University of Minnesota Duluth player had trouble handling that. It's cleared back down now by Draper. And so taken again by Daly. Fourth year in the organization for Trevor Daly. As this one careened around behind to be taken by Brian Rafalski. Little feet. Oh, and you can see something coming from Ott. And perhaps Datsyuk could as well, but he escapes to move this one back ahead. Datsyuk a shot, and getting a piece of that was Turco. Zetterberg wanted to play it along, could not. Trips up a man on the play, and the center ice official has flagged him. Delay penalty call is on. It is Ott trying to play further. It's off Datsyuk, curled back along for Robida. And now we will get the penalty call. Let's hear from Bob Harwood.
Guys, Todd McClellan between periods said we dodged a few bullets. Might be one of the best things we've got going for us right now. The fact that Dallas didn't capitalize on three or four glorious chances. He did note that their breakout, Dallas I'm talking about, was a lot more crisp. That's why the Brad Stewart pinch was something he doesn't want to see again that led to that 4-on-1. We need to be tighter in the offensive zone.
Bob, thank you. Amp Energy power play statistics as you see Zetterberg is boxed for tripping. There it was.
Yeah, Zetterberg was being held actually in from behind by Daly and then upended Morrow. So a good opportunity here for the Dallas Stars on the power play.
So Richards gives it across. Ribeiro on back to Richards again. Holden gave it across to Robida. Had the first one. That one chipped along and is taken by Morrow. Fed to the outside once more, and it's Ribeiro with it. Inside the box is Louis Erickson. Draper drifts away. Worked back in deep. Morrow threw one off of Osgood. Reaching and diving and popping one back out to center was Draper.
Excellent effort there by Chris Draper. After that last opportunity, Doug, it almost seemed like Morrow was trying to pass it, but elevated the puck and ended up going off the body of Chris Osgood.
Spike down not once, but twice by Nick Lidstrom. Robida comes by and swings it further. Draper, a former Winnipeg Jet and teammate of Mr. Olchek, probably helped him with that move when he was a youngster. Around it's Osgood turning it into traffic, though. Erickson gave it on back. Brad Richards with it there. Returned by Zuboff to Richards, and a drive deflected and grabbed by Osgood.
Seems like the Red Wings are allowing the Dallas Stars, if they want, to shoot the puck from the middle of the ice. You know Brendan Morrow is going to be standing in front of the net, but Zuboff back to Richards. Brendan Morrow just missed redirecting that puck. Good puck movement there, moving it side to side. And the Dallas Stars want to expose anything on the Red Wing penalty kill. It seems that the Red Wings are allowing them to shoot the puck from the middle of the ice.
Would you?
If it's there.
That's not something you want to do as a Red Wing defender. Is Filppula with a shot that is blocked off and then piled back into play by Turco.
And again, with the puck movement not going side to side, that forces Detroit to move, and you want to get him in between the rotation, and that opens up the middle of the ice, especially out high.
Miettinen handcuffed Richards, but he's able to play it back to Madonna off Miettinen and given back from Richards to Zuboff. Richards once more. Standing near the front is Hagman. It's given over to Zuboff. Shot one across. Madonna is shot wide. Zuboff again. Miettinen to the back. Richards holds it there. Has Madonna to his right. Shoves it over for the drive that's blocked off by Cronwall. Cleared ahead to Filppula and back down.
Well, the Detroit native Mike Madonna with an outstanding opportunity. What a pass there by Sergei Zuboff. Another missed net for the Dallas Stars.
Off of Ott, played by Rafalski. Shouldered there by Winchester. Peterson tried to get it by. Rafalski could not, but reverses on back to Niskanen now. Around it comes for Winchester. Wisconsin product played it on further now for Ott. Shoves it around behind. Winchester battling there. A big man at 6'5". Winchester worked to the corner. shoved a bit there by Stewart. Puck to the half boards, reaching in his clearing. Sent around behind, and still the Stars work it, and a little back pass in front. Rapalski cut that one off. Cannot clear, though. Winchester rocked a little bit by Lebda. Around it comes to the front, and Osgood is piled onto by Winchester, and the net is dislodged.
Good shift for the fourth line again for the Dallas Stars.
Time to take a look at the Dodge storyline for the tilt. Johan Franzen out. Henrik Zetterberg, eighth goal of the playoffs. And that shot by Robida got the Stars on the board, but it's the only one they have right now.
Well, two power play goals, very similar, Doc, as I mentioned in the first period, going through the box, the seam between the defensemen and the forwards on each team's penalty killing. And then the opportunity by Mike Modano, same type of play, just missed the net. Right part of your screen, Brian Rafalski runs over Brad Winchester. Did a nice job of puck protection. Looked like Brett Lebda there went grabbing to his face as well. You can see how he got hurt.
Brought on by Datsu. Brad Watson, Mark Joannes are the referees in this game tonight, and no official is without pressure in a Stanley Cup playoff game, but especially when so much was said about crease crashing in game one. This is pulled now by Datsu. Turns and wheels one across that is fielded and started back out again by Daly. Rather slow 3-on-2, but he risks one that is grabbed and held by Osgood.
Well, Tomas Holmstrom in his own crease, Doc, but he loves to make a living. And here early in the first period, and then here in the second period, a shot from Holmstrom goes off the shin pad of Tomas Holmstrom. I don't think there's any doubt that should have been goaltender interference in game one. Nothing was called, a goal for Holmstrom, and then they're here in game two tonight. Henrik Zetterberg on the power play. Holmstrom standing in front of the net as well.
18 goaltender interference calls out of the 775 penalties called thus far in the playoffs. 15 in the first round, 3 in the second. Now I know there are half the teams in the second round than the first, but either they got the message or they got the message.
And also, too, the referees have their discretion, Doc, where they can call a goaltender interference and wave off the goal and not issue a penalty. There's a couple different ways to look at it. That one was certainly missed the other night.
A shot by Cleary went just wide. Chased down now and brought on by Richard. Sized up by Stewart, lays it across. A shot by Grossman is held by Osgood.
Great pass there by Brad Richards. Outstanding job by Grossman to jump into the play. And if you're a player on the Dallas Star bench, you take notice of where Chris Osgood's positioning is. Opportunity, look how far out he is. So maybe the next opportunity, you put your head down, you fake a shot, and you continue on, change the angle. Osgood is way out of his net. Maybe you give yourself an opportunity to shoot at the empty net, get him moving, or maybe pass it back the other way. You got to go to school, even though you might not be on the ice. Let's take a look at what the opposing goaltender is doing, and you get that opportunity. Maybe you put it in the back of your head, Doc, and you use it.
But the other thing about the back of the head was what Turco did in the first period. That was the other part of getting the message, responding with the stick. And the officials let him do it.
Let him know you're there.
Right. Centering pass off of Turco, lifted off the glove of Hudler, and started back onto Winchester again.
Good smart play there on McCarty. Just get it to the net.
Lebda run into by Winchester. Ott rocks in as well. Winchester now to the outside. Played back on by Nordstrom. Some large guys out there that are prone to hitting. Laid on back to the point. Niskanen a shot. Deflected and then it skittered wide of the cage. Delayed penalty call coming up against Detroit. Unable to get a shot away, Peterson. And now we'll get the call. So a power play coming up for Dallas. They trail by only one here, midway in the second. Important time of the game. Chris Chelios sits for a hold. Dallas 1-for-2 on the power play.
The fourth line again for Dave Tippett. Ott, Winchester, Peterson there. Winchester and interferes with Chelios a little bit, and then Chelios wraps his arms around Winchester, draws a penalty. And Chelios shaking his head, not happy with the call, as Chris Osgood was over at the Detroit bench getting some equipment looked at.
In their wins, you would expect them to do better, and they have. A 30% effectiveness rate on their power play when they have won games. This is a team that is 4-3 away from home, trying to split this series so they can take it back home, where they are 4-2. Detroit perfect at home, 6-0, and now having to kill off another power play to the Dallas Stars, that Madonna will move in to take the draw with Draper. That is won by the Red Wings and cleared, so they have to start deep. Draper up front, as well as Cleary. Prowalski in back, along with Lidstrom. Ribeiro is out on this power play, along with Brendan Morrow. Laid across by Richards, played on by Robidoux. And the other of the Stars is Mike Madonna, as we get an offside. And it's an offside pass, so the faceoff will come all the way to the Hockey Town circle.
And from our Burger King teleshare, watch the help here. The faceoff win, but you need help. There's Cleary, gets the puck back to Lidstrom. Beautifully executed again. Brian Rafalski on the wall. Draper with the faceoff win. Help from Cleary, chip it back to Lidstrom. No hesitation. High and hard off the glass. Down the ice, and let's take a look at the face-off domination going on.
62.5% in game one, and a steal, and through traffic trying to finesse further and knock down was Draper. He comes to the bench on a change, but 35 seconds have gone off the penalty clock. Ribeiro finessed it by, goes in to get it. Zetterberg on him. It's around to Lidstrom. Trouble with the referee, though, in positioning. And so it is flipped along by Zetterberg again, and this time they're unable to clear once more.
Good play there by Morrow. Keep the puck alive.
Richards walks it, drops it back onto Ribeiro. Morrow peels off. The captain took that pass, but his pass was blocked and cleared by Velpola. So Richards comes by. Zetterberg to the bench, replaced by Datsyuk. They haven't given up much there. Selke nominee in each case. Deflected off the high glass. Ricocheted across Winchester. Gave it on back to the point while staggering. Thrown across by Ribeiro and taken by Richards. Angles one to Zuboff. Zuboff tried to work in front. Kicked aside by Osgood and played back to the corner by Zuboff to Ribeiro. And out in front, guided away. And after it is Dallas Drake, but it is played on back to his goaltender by Richards. Turco carried it across the line, I thought, but he must have been clever with it because he was not called for being outside the trapezoid.
Dave Tippett must really like and see what we're seeing from up here, Doc. He's got his fourth line out here on the power play.
Getting a penalty here. It'll be on Brad Stewart.
And it's going to be a trip. There's that opportunity with Steve Ott standing in front of that from Sergei Zubov's opportunity. And from our Coke Zero goal cam. Boy, that puck rode up to almost the shaft of the stick of Steve Ott and almost went in off of Cronwall in front of the net. So a short lit 5-on-3 here, Doc, for the Dallas Stars with Stewart going into the box. Only 8 seconds of 5-on-3.
See this again.
And there's Toby Peterson. Speed to the outside, and then Stewart overcommitted. He cut back to the middle of the ice. And Peterson got upended.
First 5-on-3 of this series for Dallas, but as Eddie said, it only 8 seconds. Zetterberg chews up most of that. Make that all of it now at that cost. Turco able to finesse it by. So it is now a 5-on-4, more conventional power play for the Red Wings to defend as Ribeiro moved in. Double team there, reaching as Chelios forced it away, but it's gotten by Niskanen, played to the front, but Lidstrom lost though to Ribeiro. Has Matt Niskanen at the back and gave it to him. Walked it on and played to Ribeiro, but through. Allowed to go near Morrow. Battles there with Chelios. Coming by Madonna, taken away by Lidstrom, and cleared. Turco just wants to make the pass with it, and he can't.
Well, for a second there, I thought he was going to put it in his own net.
Dangerously close the last time, it seemed to me, and stick handling over that diagonal line with possession. Meanwhile, this is on back to Lidstrom and wheeled back along by Chelios. Came onto the point for Ribeiro, though. And then across to Niskanen. Lays it on across once more for Sergei Zubov. Gliding in through the box was Madonna with back to Niskanen. And a shot is fought and held by Osgood. Referees watching very carefully. Any action near the goal crease?
Well, Sergei Zubov with the pass to Matt Niskanen. There, Brendan Morrow. He gets to the front of the net. Kind of takes a wave at it. We can see Morrow get his body completely in front of Osgood, so he impairs his vision. Not able to see the shot. But great rebound control there, Doc, by Chris Osgood. Because if there's any rebound there, Morrow's got a great chance.
Rafalski connected on to Cronwall. And Cronwall saw that one kept alive by Richards, though given up to Rafalski. And this time it goes back down. And a penalty is coming up. And it's going to be on Dallas. It is a hold, and for 39 seconds, four against four.
It's going to be on Brad Richards. Turnover by the Stars in the offensive zone. Then the Red Wings are able to clear the puck. Pass Richards, a forward playing the point on the power play. And a holding call on Brad Richards. Take a look at the replay, the left part of your screen, the clear by Rafalski. And then the hold on Dan Cleary. Four on four for 39 seconds. Playing four on four, you gotta play man on man. D half forwards, four half to D. You gotta make sure you're having communication.
Both these teams earlier in the playoffs have played about 18 and a half minutes of four against four. Neither has scored, nor have they given one up. And only seven in 70 games of these playoffs. Turning with this now as Robidoux gives it on to Trevor Daley. Is it because there's a defensive posture on the part of both teams?
Absolutely, Doc.
Here's Hagman trying to slip it on through. Cannot. Saying no was left up. Lifted along and a little tap by Samuelson. Gives it to Cronwall. Drifts and rifles it back in.
Good smart play there by Cronwall. At the end of his shift, he's tired. Make a smart play. Might have had a chance to make a play, but you never know. You turn the puck over and you give up an odd man situation. At the end of a long shift, you're tired. Nothing good's going to come out of that.
Power play on for Detroit. Holmstrom able to shrug that one down. Backhanded it across for Nick Lidstrom. Looks back to Rafalski, who had the gun loaded. It's across now for Datsyuk. Pivots away. Sends one. Zetterberg a shot that went wide. Rafalski again turned on to Datsyuk. Gives across. Lidstrom a drive. Save Turco. A cluster of players in front. He's back up to his feet as it's cleared off Rafalski and down.
A great battle in front of that with Holmstrom and Turco. We talk about it time and again.
Datsyuk holds, throws it across, and Rafalski plays the bounce, settled it down. Nice work to shove it to the front, cleared, but not out from Norrstrom. Lidstrom across to Rafalski, drive, and a headhunter got the glass, and then bounced off Datsyuk.
I think Turco's going to get a penalty here, Doc, for slashing Holmstrom in front of the net.
It's turned to Datsyuk. Fed on back to Lidstrom, drive! And that one blocked down in front, touched by the Stars, and that's the call. Earlier in the game, I applauded the equalizer.
Well, early in this power play, Doc, watch Marty Turco. Positioning, quick little shot to the back of the head, try to knock the helmet across. Impair his vision a little bit. And then a slash in the back of the legs. Holmstrom, a little bit of an embellishment there. There's a little bit of a chop in the back of the leg. 5-on-3 coming up for the Red Wings. Let's go down to ice level with Bob.
Eddie, it's one thing to retaliate against the opposition, but Marty Turco was off a few seconds before that. He looked around for some help from the referees. You can tell it's starting to get under his skin again. He's lost a little bit of focus right now, and obviously they can't afford that.
Five against three. Cronwall, and that deflected up into the mesh, out of play.
Great shot block there by Brendan Morrow. Quick execution, face-off win, the second power play unit. Again, no Johan Franzen in the game because of concussion-like symptoms. A beautiful shot block there by Brendan Morrow.
It is Cronwall across. One-timer is held by Turco, and that came from Samuelson. You know, on a 1 to 10 scale, that chop looked like a 3 to me. But I know you have to call those, don't you?
It's almost the intent, right?
Yeah.
Dan Cleary getting an opportunity on the power play again with Johan Franzen out of the lineup. Second power play unit. Mike Babcock stays with that second power play unit here. It's 5-on-4 now.
And this one careened back to center, and so Samuelson must go back.
Nice job there by Madonna to go ahead on that draw. Clear the zone.
So Samuelson brings it on. Had Filppula decided to go for Hudler. Slugged along by Turco. A bouncing ball all over the place that is not cleared by Madonna, but then carried back out and thrown in by Grossman.
Marty Turco very active with his stick. Filppula was going hard to the net. Turco gave him a little stick treatment from behind, and Filppula went crazily into the ice.
Samuelson holding, gives it on to Cronwall. Back to Samuelson, drive, and that got the glass. Standing in front of Turco is Dan Cleary, and this one is forced on out to center as we're halfway through the 5-on-4 power play. Ben Hudler laid it ahead, and that knifed away from Holmstrom and played safely back. Sergei Zubov with the long shove ahead. Hagman brings it on, wants to shoot, does, and a riser got the glass. And it careened back to center. Well, I know there's nervousness and there's concentration and everything else, but so many Dallas opportunities have gone wide or high. Even the shorthanded one you just saw, brought back now by Holmstrom and handed across for Zetterberg. Across and a half-speeder that causes Ryan Rafalski to look up at the sky.
You know, Doc, and how many chances are Dallas going to get? We're going to go back to that play I mentioned about the stick by Marty Turco tripping Valtteri Filppula. Another look from in behind Turco. He was just trying to break his fall there, Doc. He was just trying to make sure that he was
staying
up on one skate.
How many meetings have you been in as a player or as a coach have conducted saying, let's get him moving side to side, let's get under his skin? It's just a part of it.
It's repetitive. Probably every meeting. Coach tells you, get on this guy, be physical. He doesn't like it. Get in front of the goaltender. He doesn't like to be bumped.
Here is Zetterberg escaping. Oh, and a safe rebound is sent wide by Datsyuk. On back to Lidstrom. Gives on to Zetterberg. Bounced off Madonna. Took a swat from him. Zetterberg around behind to Datsyuk. Right back to Zetterberg. Knocked down to the ice is Holmstrom. And a penalty will be called. It'll be a 5-on-4 for Detroit yet again. 6:10 to go in the second. The Red Wings have the lead over the Stars. Oh, it was close, though. 2-1. Well, there's one of them in Sergei Zubov, member of the unified team in the 92 Olympics. We have canceling penalties. Madonna cross-check, Holmstrom diving.
Probably a couple minutes late. As far as the embellishment by Holmstrom with that slash by Turco. Turco made a great save off of Henrik Zetterberg. Great execution through the neutral zone. And a big-time stop there. A key stop in a key moment of the game by Turco on Zetterberg.
So the defensive-minded 4-against-4 situation arises again as Zubov taps it along. My colleague has drawn some interest from a number of parties about his feeling on diving calls when you have two penalties called on the same play, and that is
negate the original penalty if somebody gets caught diving.
So Madonna would not be called.
That's
and
right.
Holmstrom would.
And you would be penalized for that and you'd be shorthanded.
And your theory is it would stop it pretty fast.
Well, I think it would impact a lot of the guys that, again, we talk a lot about it. And it's an art and it's a skill and all players try to buy themselves a call every once in a while. But I'm a big believer that you would eliminate a lot of them if you did that.
My goodness, Zetterberg bought a lot of space there, and Datsyuk nearly got some more, but Turco was able to jab it away. Datsyuk right back again. Twisted a pass. Clipped from a shot that went wide. Fought on by Rafalski. Worked further by Richards. Coming by is Datsyuk. And at least it goes as far as center before Datsyuk scraps some more. Whacked on back now, and Rafalski gave it back across, and here's Zetterberg with a little more space moving in. Zetterberg crossed, gave it on over. Samuelson, a shot that's trapped and held by Turco. 4:46 to go. Second period of play. Still a one-goal game in Detroit.
Back at the Joe, the Wings have a 2-1 lead. Here's Dan Cleary. Have you established a wear and tear effect with all the time in the offensive zone?
You know, I think we're starting to wear on their defense, so they're just starting to get a little bit tired. Got to put pressure on Zuboff and Robidoux especially. You know, they've got a young defensive core besides those two.
Dan, does this thing come off in the playoffs, or is this for the run?
Well, I wish it could come off, but I think it's off for the run. It's good protection, and I'd rather not go through that experience again.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Mark.
Okay, Doc.
He was saying yesterday that the doctors say it is 5 months usually that you have to keep that. It's been three, and the next two are very critical to his team, and he'd sure like to be rid of it.
When a doctor tells you it's 5 months, you usually start asking about two and a half or three in.
Skipped in front, a diving play made by Robidoux.
It's interesting, Doc, when we talk about the defenseman, the first two guys he mentioned was Robidoux and Zuboff, the most skilled and creative guys on the back end.
This is back to Daly. Rister blocked off by Osgood and helped along by Lidstrom. And outletted ahead now for the carry-on by Brian Rafalski. Dropped it back to Samuelson. Faked the drive, then shot one. No shooting lane available there as Daly blocked it. On back to Rafalski and a shot that went well wide. So now Ribeiro shakes it across to Daly. Both teams get a man back. And the bouncer is sent on back further where Rafalski will go back to play. American out of the University of Wisconsin, Brian Rafalski, Detroit native, sees this one come ahead now to Helm. Helm with a wrist shot that is blocked aside. He had the first goal of this game, and it was a beauty. Just 4.5 minutes into the first period. Ribeiro pushed one that went off Stewart. He whacked it on back to center.
A launch shift here for Ribeiro.
Five against five was something you talked about earlier. I know we haven't seen much of it this period, but evaluate the two teams five against five in the game.
I think it's been dead even, Doc, with the five-on-five play. Good chances for both. Good defensive play for both teams. Difference is a power play goal for Detroit.
Though Dallas has done a better job of staying out of the box than Detroit has. This is played back up the boards for Miettinen. Just pinned right off at the Detroit bench by Darren McCarty. Off of Helm's stick.
Haven't seen Yuri Lehtinen in a long time, Doc. Again, that collision with Brendan Morrow in the first period.
You were mentioning earlier he got some stitches for that. Here is Maltby with a drive, and that deflected high off the glass from Turco.
I just got word he's in the training room. Dallas Stars locker room being evaluated by the team doctors.
Thank you very much for that update, too, that came to us from down below.
It was a nasty collision.
Brought back ahead by Hagman. Hagman moves on, and he's got Richards dropped to him. The return, and Hagman goes down, and a penalty coming up to Chelios. Delayed call is on. And so the Red Wings will be called, and Dallas will have an advantage for either two or four. And then Chelios gets in and has to be guided aside by a linesman.
A second period, a penalty of the period by Chelios, and a quick little shot by Chelios to the face of Hagman. I don't know if he's ever, I don't think most players ever go to reference, oh, that was a good call, or.
He's pointing to the butt end of his stick.
I don't know if Hagman was cut or not.
It goes up as a 2-minute minor. And so Dallas given yet another chance to get back into this. They trail by only one. One shot, one dirty goal off somebody's back, one off a stick, anything they'll take.
And Turco's made some good saves, Doc, to allow this to be a one-goal game. And that's what you need. That's what Artie Turco's done all playoff, all season long.
19 shots to 11 in the game, Detroit. Another power play opportunity underway here for the Dallas Stars. Nice move, Ribeiro gets in, drive, save, Austin, and he covers. The Red Sea parted.
As we talked about, the regular season leader in shooting percentage. 27 goals and 107 shots in the regular season. With a great move at the blue line. Good stop there by Osgood. No rebound again.
It was on net, so that's at least a positive there for Dallas. Lifted by Ribeiro back to Robidoux, then on a cross. drive, and that blocked off by Nick Lidstrom. He and Morrow test the boards. It's coming by as Erickson. And Erickson able to take it away and guide it on back to Richards again. Richards with a back pass that is read by Rafalski, turns, got it on to Zetterberg, and Zetterberg just dropped it back to center. 100 seconds left in the second, and 70 seconds left on this power play. Richards could not get in because of Zetterberg. That went off Filppula, carried on with speed by Zetterberg. Zetterberg turning, and a shot fought off by Turco, then held in front. The puck check by Turco denied Filppula what might have been a great shot. He continues to give his team a chance here. A shorthanded opportunity for Detroit. Played back along now by Ribeiro. Swung one that went away from Stewart. Right back to Ribeiro. It comes again from Morrow. Ribeiro just holding, shook it onto the back to Richards. And Richards with a shot that went off a stick wide. Rebound. And emerging with it is Ott. Then it's laid back along to Zuboff in the final minute of play in this period. Zuboff sped it behind to Morrow. Works back to the outside. Ribeiro shovels it onto Richards. Richards hands to Zuboff. Drive. And it went over the glove hand of Osgood. And back down.
Well, that just missed banking off of Steve Ott.
Off Ott stick on an offside pass, and it'll come all the way back into the Dallas end.
Well, right before that opportunity for Sergei Zuboff, Steve Ott pushes with Brad Stewart in behind the play. The quick little back check, and then Zetterberg possesses the puck. He knows he's got a tired Stefan Robitaille out on the ice, gets to the outside, and you called it, Doc, the quick stick of Marty Turco right after that. The Dallas Stars all circled away. Nobody stopped in front of the net. There, Filppula was looking to go from his forehand to his backhand, and that quick, active stick of Turco denied another opportunity shorthanded for the Red Wings.
Niskanen nudged it on. It's played on to Hagman. Getting in his way effectively was Rafalski as this is lobbed on back on the bounce, Mattias Norrström. Penalty time is up. Chelios out of the box. Stays out right now as Modano connects up with Hagman. Tried to play it back in, could not. Turned on now by Datsyuk and fed back off. Nice move by Cleary to the back. Rafalski, a shot that had to be blocked aside by Turco. To the outside, Samuelson popped one behind. It's shoveled on now for Datsyuk. Fed it to the back again. Nick Lidstrom with a wrist shot. That one went wide. 4 seconds left in the period. Here's Datsyuk again. They want him to shoot, and time expires as he was forced off by Modano. In the period, 9 shots for Detroit. 2 period totals, 21. 8 shots for Dallas after having only 4 in the first. A better period for the Stars, but they still trail by that score of 2-1. Stay tuned for the Verizon Wireless Intermission Report with Bill Patrick, Keith Jones, and Brian Engblom after this break.
The Stanley Cup Playoffs on Versus are brought to you by Bud Light. Endless refreshment from start to finish. Bud Light keeps it coming. And by Verizon Wireless, official wireless service provider of the NHL.
No carryover penalties nor power plays here at Joe Louis Arena. It is still 2-1 in favor of Detroit. What impressed you in that area?
Well, I think Detroit Red Wings, just the way they're able to control the pace of the game, and, you know, sometimes it gets up and down opportunities for both teams, and I really like the way that Dallas has bounced back after not skating in game one. And Marty Turco has been sensational, especially in that second period when you're having a tough time scoring goals. You need your goaltender to be active, not necessarily like that or like that, but making key saves at the right time in a one goal game. He's made some spectacular saves real quick with the stick. We know he's very active when handling the puck, but also a quick little poke check there of Valtteri Filppula. So a lot of good things here so far for both teams, Doc. But again, Detroit Red Wings, you can play any way you want, and they dictate more times than not on the type of the pace the game is going to be played at. The transition game for Detroit Red Wings. Turn the puck over them on the blue line. Make you pay.
See the goal differential in the third period. Another bit of brain candy to chew on here as we see how the players execute. Filppula gives it over. It is Samuelson flipping, and that one turned aside to the high glass by Turco. Sent along by Filppula, who has done a splendid job on that line as their replacement tonight for Johan Franzen. Again, concussion-like symptoms, has had headaches since the early part of round 2. will be evaluated on Monday and will remain in Detroit for that. Here is Holmstrom, able to pull away. He's got Lidstrom behind and connects with him. Played back ahead, but away from Cronwall. Guided on back now for the turn by Louis Eriksson. Given back to Robidon, a shot! Getting a piece of that was Osgood, and it caroms all the way back down. So good start for Dallas here in the third. That one forced along, but right to Zetterberg, though. Flipped one that was blocked down by Robidon. Has it again. Chased off by Brendan Morrow, so he can't get a pass away. Good defensive work by the Dallas captain. So it's Ribeiro shaking it back. Red Wing swirl. It's passed on through Datsyuk, but it caromed on to Rapalski. Rapalski gave it on for the blast back in by Holmstrom, and a bad reaction there by Turco. Rebound came off the stick of Zetterberg. Centering pass. Turco had that. Lost it. Served in front. He's able to grab it, and this time, hang on.
Well, not once, but twice. The Red Wings tried to bounce the puck in off of Marty Turco, but this play all started with the shot from the point. I think it might have went off of Stefan Robidon, who went diving there. There's the one chance by Zetterberg, and then Datsyuk again tries to bank it in off Marty Turco. You just never know. Get the puck towards the net. A big rebound there, and Robidon, desperation mode, just not allowing or trying not to allow Zetterberg with a breakaway from about 10 feet in. We're talking about Johan Franzendock, and also Yuri Lehtinen, who collided with Brendan Morrow in the first period. Still not on the bench.
Lehtinen's shot deflected wide. It is a leg injury.
He only had one shift in that second period.
Angled back in for Lehta, who turns. Brett Lehta lifted that one back along, but it is knifed away from Hagman and taken on by Dallas. Drake recovers again and lobbed it in and able to escape, but then the puck left behind by Kirk Maltby. So Niskanen banked it around behind. First 2 minutes of play here in the third period at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Done. Red Wings ahead 2-1. And my colleague Mr. Olczyk has determined that the 5-on-5 play in the first two periods, which was a concern for both teams, has been even. Banked back along, but taken by Morrow, shaken in front. A good denial there defensively by Brett Lehta. 3-on-2 developing. On comes Helm with it. Dropped it on back. Hudler across and a shot by McCurdy is held.
Well, good execution there of a 3-on-2 from the blue line in. And Darren McCurdy with a quick, hard shot. No rebound given up by Turco. People crashing the front of the net.
Had a 4-point game when he was a part of the Grand Rapids Griffins. His first hat trick since the one he wove against Patrick Waugh in 2002. And those are his two professional career hat tricks against the Lake Erie Monsters and the Colorado Avalanche. Bob.
Fellas, it applies in the third period. Mark Lamb of the Dallas Stars says we're simply doing too much chasing, and he connected that to being dominated in the faceoff circle. He says if we stay down, we're going to see more defensemen pinching. And he says the Winchester Ott Peterson line has really led the charge in terms of puck possession and being hard to play against in the offensive zone. They need plenty of that.
So we'll see them more often, I would assume, from that. The former coach up here felt that that would be the case and should be the case based on what you just said, as that one is turned long by Turco, tumbles down, gets up slowly, but play is going the other way.
Well, I like what Dave Tippett's theory is there, Doc. He's rewarded those guys with power play time. So trust me, everybody on the bench notices it.
This is Cleary ahead. Couldn't pass it through. Good stick work by Zuboff. Sent along now, but off of Filppula. Charging ahead to keep play alive was Rapalski. That one careened on to Sergei Zuboff. And Zuboff is able to hand on for the carryout by Brad Richards. Flung it wide, and the bouncer came over near Eriksson, but it's turned back along by Rapalski. Tried to shuffle it from Richards, and it bounced in front where Holmstrom gave it up. Lundqvist lost it, and it is lobbed on back. Very carefully played first 3.5 minutes in this third.
Yeah. To tell that by just a lot of the neutral zone play, people back, not want to get caught. Again, if you don't have any play and you see 4 and 5 guys lined up across the red line, puck's got to get in deep. Ott tried to take a piece of Lidstrom there.
Top 3 defensive teams left in the playoffs are 3 of the 4 survivors here. Turco snatched that one up and then just played it back to center where Rafalski touched it across.
You have to be aware when Marty Turco's playing that puck.
Here's Ribeiro escaping, and a shot is trapped and held by Osgood.
Well, one end, a good stop there by Chris Osgood, and then back a little bit earlier, Cleary upends Marty Turco. A little bit of a mishandling from our Coke Zero goal cam. Good job by the Red Wings there. When goaltenders play, the puck are very active, and there's a chance by Ribeiro on Osgood. You want to get on a goaltender right away. You don't want to anticipate where he's going. You want to put pressure on him right away. And what is he going to do? You go straight on him, Doc, and he's behind the net like that, what are his options? Oh, either up the left wing boards or the right wing boards. A lot of times you'll see guys try to guess where the goaltender is going to pass it. So the first guy goes hard on the goalie, and the other two guys, if you're not in the middle of a change, should go and take away those options for the goalie.
Niskanen, a shot deflected off the pad of Osgood.
Good redirect there by Winchester.
Brought ahead by Maltby, sent in. But Turco flipped it away from him as he went up high on the glass. Winchester brings it right back, sized up by Cronwall. More ways than one. Pushed right back in, and the hit came from Brad Stewart. Now Cronwall working on Peterson. Richards is out with these two guys right now. It is pulled away by Stewart and gotten on to Drake. And then Yuri Hudler. And check that, Dallas. It's Chris Draper.
With Dallas being down a forward, we'll see a lot of different line combinations for Dave Tippett. Yuri letting it out. The lower leg injury, as you mentioned, Doc.
Modano swooped near that one. Got a backhander away and a great kick save by Osgood.
Oh, what a stop.
First off, how did Modano make something out of that? It looked like a totally broken play, and then Osgood reacted brilliantly.
Well, he was shot out of a cannon, Mike Modano, and in one fell swoop, turned around in a little backhander.
No icing here. Chelios back. Turns it along to Brett Lebda. Stars making another player change. Deliberately brought back on by Darren McCarty. Second effort, he's able to push it back in, but an offside is called.
Get quick plays through the neutral zone. Sometimes you need a little bit of a luck, take a good bounce for you, and that's what happens. A pass by Nordstrom. Modano, a quick little chip over the stick of Chelios. Watch the play. Right there, he just chips it up over. He stays with it, and then on a backhand, a great left pad save. Off the stick of Mike Modano by Chris Osgood. But again, that speed through the neutral zone. Good idea there by Nordstrom just to get the puck up there. Great chance.
Zuboff brought it on, handed it on to Ribeiro. Seen a lot of ice time already this period. That went into the catching glove of Chris Osgood, and he will hold.
That save was so good. We're going to take a look at it again, Doc. Puck is rolling. Chelios not sure where it is, and on edge. Just all desperation by Modano. Stay with the puck, find it, just get it towards the net. You never know. Might bounce off of Chelios, could go in, could be a rebound.
This one is swept under Ribeiro, but it's knocked away by Rafalski, who had some help from Lidstrom to make that play. Holmstrom bounced one ahead, could not be reached by Datsyuk. It's the kind of game that Dallas has played in these playoffs and won before, as a shot by Morrow was deflected wide.
Yeah, you don't get this far without. Well, sometimes not playing your best in winning games.
This one came off of Morrow's stick. I mean, defensively, they've been pretty strong.
Yep.
And when they haven't been, Turco has been there.
I mean, they've been chasing a puck a lot. I don't think there's any doubt about that. Again, they've skated more. And that's the one thing you want to do. Stay out of the box and skate more than did in game one.
Holmstrom a shot, and it went off the pad of Turco. Datsyuk was hit hard across the way by Winchester. Punched right behind by Turco and taken by Robidoff. Away from Filppula. Change in lines for Detroit. Dan Cleary is out there with Filppula and Samuelson. Robidoff reversed. It's taken by Samuelson, and he just couldn't get loose, and then he shot a riser. And the reason he couldn't get the pass away was Marty Turco anticipated and swept the stick out there.
That was Billy Smith-like, Doc.
It was, and he
just
was Billy Smith-like earlier in the game, too.
Just didn't get any human flesh on that one.
He's got this one and tosses it on, and that Kareem free to Chelios for a shot that is turned aside by Turco. A deceptively strong shot by Chris Chelios.
Long shift here for Daly and Robidoff. They can't get off the ice. They wanted to go off. They can't get it. Daly comes off. Zuboff is on, but Robidoux's had a long, long shift.
Louis Eriksson denied there by the reach of Draper. Around it comes for Osgood to play back to the corner. Lebda able to scale one back off that can be taken further and outletted on now to Draper. Given across to Samuelson. Shoves it in. He comes to the bench for a change. Turco plays it up the boards. And it comes to center where Cronwall is able to tip it back. Niskanen laid it back in. 12-10 left in the third. Pope back along near Dallas Drake, but moving in and being denied was Richards. Unfortunate bounce of the puck, though the Stars are able to lay it back into the Stewart corner now. He and Richards cancel. Coming by is Lebda. Picked up there by Draper. Lost. And gotten back on for a little flip by Richards. That's free to the half boards, but is sent on back by Lundqvist. Played back along by Niskanen. Up for grabs and tapped on further. And can be lobbed on. Malfi sees Niskanen play this one on back, and that one careened on to Rafalski. Rafalski out there with Cronwall as the Red Wings are trying to make a change, and it's flown back ahead for Helm. Here's Helm sized up there by Grossman. Centering pass in front, and it's falling play. Did it go over the line? The Red Wings were hoping it did. We're going to get an interference call.
It's going to be on Matt Niskanen. Power play coming up for the Red Wings.
First power play of the period. Red Wings ahead by one. Niskanen in the box. Crucial time of the game, power play Detroit.
Well, Yuri Hurler throws this puck up ice, but watch the stick of Darren Helm. That looks like a high stick. He knocks it down. Watch Marty Turco. That's a high stick. That's a high stick. What ends up happening? Niskanen takes a penalty.
Will that be the difference in this? Lidstrom brings it ahead for the Detroit power play.
Definitely looked like it was a high stick.
Agreed. One for three power play Detroit. Right out front! And an opportunity there from Datsyuk was shut off by Turco. Rafalski gives back over to Lidstrom. Lidstrom handing on to Zetterberg. Zetterberg a drive! Blocked away by Turco. The net is dislodged. Play halted. Face-off in the Dallas defensive end.
Well, two guys we heard from in our open. Matty Nordstrom of the Dallas Stars and Tomas Holmstrom of the Detroit Red Wings battling in front of the net, getting position. Nordstrom with a little bit of a push, a little bit of a bump into Turco. But again, another shot to the back of the head. That's two for Turco. A couple free pops on number 96. Faceoff remains inside. Sorry, Doc.
No, in a different era, Billy Smith felt that they couldn't call him on all of them. So if it was one out of ten, that's nine free ones.
Trust me, anytime you went around the net, you knew.
You knew.
You were a little more guarded.
Fed on to Zetterberg.
But make you think twice.
Rafalski hands this one on to Lidstrom. Lidstrom around in front and trying to tip it was Holmstrom. That's who gets to it. Holmstrom around behind. Zetterberg near the front. It's flipped but into Nordstrom, who is able to clear. 10:20 left in the third, halfway through the power play.
You know what, Doc, and the one thing with the Red Wing power play is that if it isn't working on one way, they will just kind of rotate and just try to change things up a little bit and give the penalty clear something a little different look. You know, moving the D around, a big hit there, Robidoux and Lidstrom. It keeps you on your toes if you're a penalty clear.
Here is Ott, closed off enough by Samuelson that it's harmless over to Osgood and shaken across to it. Second wave is out there for Detroit now, away from the sweep of Brendan Morrow. It's carried back by Michael Samuelson. Nice spike of the puck by Turco. Swung it back over to Daly. Long toss is back down and gloved by Cronwall. Boy, Marty Turco's just really artistic with his stick tonight in particular. This carried back, well, some of it's art, right? Down to the ice goes Filppula. And some of it is just brute strength.
Everybody's definition of art is a little different.
Here is Hutler bringing it ahead. Yuri Hutler in the last seven of the power play got it onto Cleary. Threw one in front, turned aside by Turco. Forced along, but to Cronwall. Time is up on the power play. Held now by Filppula. Dealt back in deep. Little feet out in front, and Cleary a shot that is grabbed and held by Turco. And again, play is stopped. Penalty box empty. The score is still 2-1 Detroit.
The Stars are down 2-1. They have to hope Brad Richards finds his first and second round level of impact. Game two with Anaheim, a slim 3-2 lead. Richards scored late to give Dallas a rare two-goal cushion. Same situation game six, primary assist on goal number three. Dallas won the series that night. Down 2-1 in San Jose, game two, second round. Richards tied it at two with a goal, then assisted on three straight goals as they blew it wide open. Fellas, he says he eased his way in as a newcomer in the regular season, but the playoffs are where he needs to make a mark.
And that's why Les Jackson, co-general manager along with Brett Hull, brought him in.
His team has scored two goals in the series. He has not been a part of either of those. Punched across by Zubov. Elm, a backhander that was blocked off by the defense.
Boy,
reached by Zubov.
Boy, is he quick there through the neutral zone. Or, excuse me, through the slot area there, Helm.
He was strong up the wing, and the speed is what makes that shot more effective because he got it more open as he did in scoring the first goal. Here is Brett Lepta around behind, smeared out of the play and just now getting up as McCarty. The pass skipped through him, but at the half boards, it's Chelios with a shot that is deflected wide. Kudler tried to shake it on. Forced back by Grossman. Half boards, Chelios leaned a man down. That was Richards. Right back it comes near McCarty, who is hit by Grossman. Punched along by Turco, settled there and laid back out eventually from Zubov for Winchester and in. Osgood went strong side. Lidstrom, then Zetterberg, then back. Clock the enemy of the Stars. Not its worst enemy just yet. Still 8:03 to go in regulation time. One shot away from getting a tie. Detroit one shot away from a two-goal lead, which will look very large the way this game's been played, and particularly the way this period's been played, as we get a rare icing call.
Coming back into the Detroit zone. The reminders on the bench for both teams. Gotta get the puck in and out at the blue line. No hope plays either way. And if you're Detroit, you got a chance. You know what? Yeah, we can jump in. We saw Brett Lepta. You called his name, Doc. Defenseman, he was in below the goal line. So again, you got to make sure that puck is getting in and out. Change before you're tired, and your coaches, everybody on the bench will continue to talk about that and repeat it over and over until the end of the game.
Normal length of a shift and now a third period length.
35 to 40 regular, and now you're probably about 25.
Zetterberg a shot, and it's turned aside by Marty Turco. But the important thing is to come to the bench before you get
exactly.
Caught.
You don't want to get caught out there.
This is Rafalski back to take for Detroit. Laid back across by Zetterberg to Lidstrom. Returned back to Henrik Zetterberg. Marches ahead and weaves his way in and fires into the catching glove of Turco. Guided it aside now to Brendan Morrow. Banked it around behind for Robidoux.
Boy, that play all started back in the defensive zone. Quick little pass, give and go Zetterberg to Lidstrom and then back to Zetterberg. He's able to get that shot on goal.
Dallas Drake's unit is out there right now with Chris Draper and Kirk Maltby. Stewart gave it ahead, brought back up by Drake. Run into by Robidoux, and Drake has been hurt by that hit. He is going to the bench now. Mike Madonna with that. Sent it on across, Mietinen there. Played it on through. Hagman could not escape by the ever-present check of Chris Draper. Samuelson slowed that down and got it on to Cleary. 6.5 to go. Cleary wedged off. Puck taken by Samuelson. Slung back across, but Hagman got that. Weak pass on back. But Niskanen made something of it by giving to Madonna and then to Mietinen. Dropped back over for the carry by Matthias Norström. Norström backhanded one that went off the stick of Stewart. Played back along again by Madonna. He got it back onto Norström. Norström back to Niskanen again. Laid it back off of a man to the corner, and that was Hagman. Taken along by Filppula. Then Brett Lepta. And Lepta just flew it on across, and the Red Wings can bring it back out with under 6 minutes to go. Into the bench they come on a change of lines. Dallas doing the same.
Good to see Dallas, Doc, when they're in the offensive zone, when they're forward, move the puck back to the defenseman at the point. Has made quicker decisions with the puck. There's been some opportunities. That last chance for Niskanen, he had a chance to get it to the net right away, but he waited a second longer, gave Detroit an opportunity to take away that shooting lane. So quicker decision by the Dallas Stars defenseman in the offensive zone when they get the puck.
Are you able to tell that at the bench and get them to change that in the midst of play?
Yeah, I think you always have that eye in the sky. Stopped there by Osgood off of Richards. You always get help from people upstairs and on the bench as well.
Still 2-1 Red Wings. Mike Madonna Houston Westland, right near Detroit.
Played a lot of his amateur hockey for Little Caesars, which is owned by Mr. Mike Illich, who's the owner of the Red Wings and owner of Little Caesars Pizza.
We know where they went after every game.
I could go for one of those.
Zuboff a shot, and that blocked back out by Zetterberg, and Zuboff falls, but he's able to play it along. Geared back out by Grossman and sped back in by Zetterberg. So now it's Grossman with a little over 5 minutes to go. His team has played so much better in this game. Marty Turco has been outstanding. They're still trailing powerful Detroit by a goal. Chris Osgood has been terrific too. As a round behind, escaping as Rafalski, got the pass ahead, outletted onto Zetterberg, took a swat from behind and a second from Ribeiro. And Zetterberg just scurries around behind, denied by Grossman, puck left behind. Grossman speared though. And it is Zetterberg to the back. Rafalski playing it there. Went on through Samuelson. Around behind, it's tipped away from Datsyuk. Datsyuk wedged off by Zuboff. Reversed on back now to Morrow. Hunted down and jostled a bit by Samuelson. The pass went by, but came up to Grossman. Grossman just moved it ahead of the checkered line. Wanted to play it in, but Rafalski got in the way of that. And a nice bounce pass ahead now that comes to Filppula. Filppula trying to get by Robida. Filppula around behind, but couldn't get the pass away. And then a heavy hit that also got the referee.
Big hit, Steve Ott.
Ribeiro brings it on back. Oh, what a slam to the glass by Dan Cleary. A football-like hit by a guy wearing a partial cage. Brought back on now by Daly. And it is Osgood. Flown back along to Ott. The effective guys are out there now for Dallas, the big guys. Here's Peterson. He's got Ott in front. Peterson a shot. Directed off his skate. Twisted around in front. They poke away at it. Can't get it there. A helmet goes flying. Meanwhile, across it's taken by Maltby. He's able to lob one ahead, and it goes by Dallas Drake and back down.
That helmet was Chris Draper. Steve Ott in front of the net. Two good chances in front of net for the Stars.
Daly played it across. Hagman couldn't get through. Sends it between the point men back out. Robida brings it right back. Leading point getter among defensemen for his team. Sees this one escape now to Chelios behind. Rushed there by Miettinen. The pass misfires for Lebda. Charges after it with Robida and got some help to Karamat off the glass, but not yet out. Puts right back around in front, and Chelios buried a man. Meanwhile, back the other way, it's Datsyuk. Datsyuk holding, crosses, still there, out in front, tried to shake it by Cook. Everyone looking around, it's in the near corner. Picked up by Hagman. And Hagman is able to stagger by one. Couldn't get by Zetterberg, but then it's flung back in by Richards. What chaos back in the Detroit end of the ice a moment ago.
That puck took a funny bounce off one of the stanchions in the glass, and it looked like Dallas had something going until Chelios came to the rescue.
Mike Modano able to step out under 2.5 to go regulation. His team has to get one. The chant is "Let's go Red Wings." The play now is Morrow's. Richards moves in for that one, flicked it around behind. Plenty of Red Wings there. Filppula able to sidestep Morrow and bring it ahead. He's got Cleary ahead on the right and gives it to him. Cleary is jostled there, but it's brought back on by Samuelson, who pivots. Nordstrom is able to get reset as this is passed on to Filppula. Nordstrom put the shoulder into him. Samuelson closed off by Richards. Coming by is Filppula again. Dallas would like to get a line change here. Meanwhile, it comes across, and now they can do it as it's brought on by Modano. Modano gave it over to Morrow, but he lost it. So now it's Cronwall with a minute 45 to go in regulation time. Samuelson pitchforked it right back in. Marty Turco was out at the hash marks, but that was more to make a play than leave the ice.
As soon as Dallas gets control down in the offensive zone, you got to think Turco's going to make a beeline for the bench.
It's brought along and thrown back in by Lundqvist. He's at the hash marks now. Played along by Ribeiro, but he's jostled off by Zetterberg. Puck bounced loose. Nearly at the blue line is Turco, but not out yet. Cleared on back to Robida. Shunted around behind, and now Turco has come to the bench for the extra attacker. Battle torn, thrown back off by Cronwall. Meanwhile, it is taken on in a four-man jostle there, and it's brought back ahead by Kurt Maltby. Lobs one wide. 1 minute to go. Six attackers for Dallas. They have to get one. Louis Erickson brings it ahead. Denied by Nick Lidstrom. It's punted behind by Osgood. Lundqvist ran off his man, Rafalski. It skipped on through, and it's Ribeiro now. Ribeiro around behind to Lundqvist with Erickson in front. To the outside. inside Ribeiro. Gave it on back, and once more it's whacked at by Ribeiro, but taken by Cleary, and Cleary lobs it back down. 36 to go. Robidoux gliding around behind, has Ribeiro out in front, but he has to play it across circle to circle to Zuboff. Head up, he got the pass ahead. Richards fiddled it back in on the backhand. Rapalski there to get it. Run off by Morrow. They cancel in the corner. And a stoppage of play and a penalty. Brandon Morrow to the box with 17 and a half to go. We've kept an eye on Chris Chelios tonight in our KFC player profile. Go ahead.
Well, 257th career playoff game, adding to the 417 career penalty minutes in the playoffs. With 4 minutes tonight, and Chris Chelios, along with his five defensive partners back on the blue line, trying to hold off the Dallas Stars here, and the Red Wings will be on a power play.
Understatement that it's a large faceoff. It is a faceoff taken about 120 feet from an empty net. First thing, you have to win that. Throw it in and pour in.
Get possession now. Will Dave Tippett have the goaltender out already? It looks like Marty Turco's got a pretty comfortable seat on the bench. I'm gonna go with no goaltender in. Technically a power play for the Red Wings, but 5-on-5 here with the goaltender out.
Burger King storyline, Franzen out. Lettinen left the game with a leg injury. Zetterberg, eighth goal of the playoffs, and that one by Darren Helm was a work of art. Big draw. Nudge back by Ott, and what do we get? A hand pass, of course. And so now it comes to the big hockey town circle.
Good job there by linesman Pierre Rassico.
2.5 seconds it required for that play. So Ott wants to draw it back, and then they sling it in and they try to make something happen by going out.
That's it, yeah, just almost make a flyer. Looks like Chris Draper has to go off the bench. He has a broken piece of equipment. He grabs Michael Samuelson's helmet off the bench.
Two best face-off men for their teams. Down to the ice goes Ott. Kicked on by Zetterberg and sent wide, but it'll be enough. Robidoux wheels behind. He's got 5 seconds. Brings it back to center. We've got a skirmish across the way, and the clock stopped with 4.9 to go.
Well, Steve Ott went right after Chris Draper. The helmet of Chris Draper, which was Michael Samuelson's helmet, came off. And then Steve Ott tracks down Chris Draper, gives him a shot with his glove on. But right off the draw, that's how the helmet comes off. Ott grabs it, pops it off the head of Draper. And as Zetterberg shot the puck down the other way, Ott was looking for Draper. He found him, kind of spun him around and gave him a quick shot with the glove on.
I think Ott figured a face-off violation there. They were tangled up and went down, but the chant by the crowd here as the penalty goes to Ott. A goalie in 5 against 4 attackers.
Yeah, Ott with the penalty, so a 5-on-3. With the goaltender out, a 5-on-4 with the extra attacker.
Zuboff with one last toss. Chris Osgood has won 8 straight. So have the Red Wings. And then a little extra afterwards, and Osgood goes down in the goal crease.
Well, Mike Ribeiro. Mike Ribeiro, after Brian Rafalski went to touch the puck, Robidoux came from one side, Ribeiro came from the other, and Ribeiro had some words for Chris Osgood, and then Ribeiro swings his stick across the top of the net and makes contact with Chris Osgood.
You see Darren McCarty at the bench, and he's not talking out toward the ice. He's talking right to the Dallas Stars players there. Osgood down. Rivero ushered away. A linesman making sure the Red Wings don't get near, but they can deliver some verbal shots.
Well, the puck gets shot in. And then there you see the swing of the stick. Not a smart play by Mike Rivero.
Whether a penalty or not, reviewable and sanctionable.
Now, you don't know if Osgood did anything to Rivero, Doc, as he went by the net there, but you cannot swing your stick like that. I don't think there's any doubt that the National Hockey League will look at that. Up 2-0 now, the Red Wings will head to Dallas for Monday night.
All right, let's see if we can roll this back a little further and see if there was any provocation here.
Yeah, Mike Ribeiro's not that type of player. He plays hard there, but look at maybe the butt end of the stick, Doc, gets into the face of Mike Ribeiro. A subtle little move with the stick. No question, Osgood got him. Now, whether or not he clipped him or not, but if you're Mike Ribeiro, you're better off to just drop your stick and go ahead and give him a shot with your hand. You cannot use your stick like that, even though Osgood started it.
So following the showers and following the flights, there may still be some action from that. But the most important thing is the final score. Red Wings up 2-0 in the series. They win game number 2 at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit by a score of 2-1. Let's get you to Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light. Here's Bill Patrick.